Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we'll discuss about the role of microorganisms in agriculture. The objectives of this module is to study their role in the agriculture field. We'll study about the different types of biofertilizers. We'll study that how biofertilizers are applied on the agriculture field, their advantages and the disadvantages of biofertilizers. Let's start with a brief introduction that what are microbes? Microbes are the microorganisms. They're the minute living organisms which are not visible by naked eye. We need a special type of instrument called microscope to analyze the microorganisms. Leeuwenhoek is known as a father of microbiology. Let's start that why microorganisms are required in agriculture field. They're required in two different ways. One as a biocontrolling agent and the other as a biofertilizers. Now what are biocontrolling agents? Biocontrolling agents are the microorganisms that are used against the pest such as weeds, insects, insecticides, etc. In simple terms, we can say that biocontrolling agents are the organisms that in turn used against the organisms. In this module, we'll be focusing only on the biofertilizer part. Let's start with that. Now, what are biofertilizers? Biofertilizers are the living formulations of microorganisms that are used for enhancing the plant growth, for the proper plant growth, or you can say for increasing the yield of product. Biofertilizers are economic and eco-friendly. That's why most of the people they need biofertilizer to use for against the enhancement of plant growth. The biofertilizers were initially identified by a Dutch scientist in 1988. In India, it was first commercially its production started in 1956 under the supervision of N.V. Joshi. A National Biofertilizer Development Center was established by Indian government at the Ghaziabad for promoting the training programs related to production of biofertilizers and that how to use the biofertilizers. They have further 6 regional biofertilizer development centers such as Bangalore, Nagpur, Jabalpur, Bhubaneswar, Hisar and Imphal. Now moving further, that the types of biofertilizers. Biofertilizers are of 3 types. First, nitrogen biofertilizer, then the phosphate biofertilizer and silicate solubilizing biofertilizers. Nitrogen biofertilizers. Nitrogen is a macronutrient that is required by the plant for its leaf growth. It helps in stimulation of chloroplast production. It enhances the fruit set. Nitrogen is used by the plant in the form of nitrate ions. What these nitrogen fertilizers do? They help in fixing the atmospheric nitrogen and making it available to the plant for its better growth and development. Nitrogen fertilizers, it means the microorganisms that are used as a nitrogen fertilizers, they are symbiotically associated with the plants. What is the meaning of symbiotic association? That means both the partners are equally benefited. They form a symbiotic association with the plant and can live freely around the plant. Further, the types of nitrogen biofertilizer. Nitrogen fixing biofertilizers are of 2 types. One is the symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria and the other one is free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. Let's discuss about the symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria. As I told earlier, that what is symbiosis? It means the mutual benefit of both the partners. They help in fixing the free nitrogen by symbiotically living inside the plant. In this process, both the partners are benefited. The whole process, the fixing of nitrogen from the atmospheric nitrogen, it undergoes inside the root nodules. What the bacteria? Bacteria, they are getting food and shelter by living inside the root nodules, and which in turn converts the atmospheric nitrogen into the available form to the plant. Examples of symbiotically fixing nitrogen bacteria are Rhizobia, Frankia, Azolla and Abina. We'll discuss these examples one by one. What is Rhizobia? It is root nodules forming bacteria and it reduces the molecular nitrogen to ammonia. It converts the atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia and then that microorganism further make it available for the plant growth. Rhizobium leguminosarum fix 60 to 132 nitrogen kg per hectare. Then Azolla anabina, the type of symbiotically fixing nitrogen bacteria, it fixes the nitrogen in association with blue-green alga. It helps in Azolla, as we know that Azolla is a free-floating water fern. It fixes the atmospheric nitrogen in paddy fields and also used as a feed substitute for livestock. Azolla biofertilizer, Azolla anabina, the living formulation of Azolla anabina as a biofertilizer, it increases the yield up to 10 to 20% in the paddy crop. Also act as a biocontrol agent as it suppresses the weed growth. The next is Frankia. Frankia is the genus of nitrogen fixing mycelial bacterium, that is actinomycetes. It's symbiotically associated with the non-leguminous plants. We discussed earlier about the rhizobia, that rhizobia work in association with the root nodule plants, that is leguminous plants, and Frankia, it is used, it goes under association with non-leguminous plants. This Frankia is capable of infecting a non-nodulating group of 8 families, mainly woody plants, called as actinorhizal plants. Table 1 describes the rhizobium species for different legumes. We can say the speciality or the rhizobium species, they are particularly crop specific. For example, the rhizobium leguminosarum is used against only the woolly pod vetch plant. Rhizobium japonicum is used for the species named Glycinic max. Its common name is soybean. In that way, there are 9 species that we have discussed in that we have mentioned in this table against rhizobium species and their target crop plant. We discussed about the symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria. Now we'll discuss about free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. Azotobacter. It was found that it is found in the roots of Phosphaenium notatum, tropical grasses, and adds 15 to 93 kilogram per hectare per annum of nitrogen to the plant, and it helps in and promotes the growth of substances like vitamins, indole acetic acid, which is an auxin, which further helps in enhancement of plant growth, and gibberellins, which increases the crop yields by 10 to 15%. Next is cyanobacteria. Or BGA, that is blue-green algae, it increases the crop yield by 10 to 15%. We discussed about the nitrogen-fixing nitrogen biofertilizers. Now we'll discuss about the phosphate biofertilizers. Similarly, first, why phosphorus is necessary, what role phosphorus plays in the plant growth. Phosphorus is a macronutrient. It helps in metabolism of crop plants. Its major role is in the cell division and photosynthesis part of the plant. If a plant is a phosphorus deficient, that is P deficient, then it shows retarded growth. As I told you that it helps in cell division. If there is no cell division, there will be no proper growth of the plant, and a plant will show a retarded growth. This phosphate biofertilizer, it works in two ways. It either solubilizes insoluble form of phosphate, or it helps in it scavenge the phosphate from soil layer and make it available for the plant. The phosphate which is in the associated form, in some inorganic form, which is not easily available for the plant, that is being solubilized by the phosphate biofertilizers, and they make it available to the plant and for good growth of the plant. So phosphate biofertilizers, it's of two types, P solubilizing and P mobilizing. P solubilizing, that is PSBs, phosphate solubilizing bacteria. Examples of PSBs are phosphate solubilizing bacteria are Pseudomonas, Bacillus, Acrobacter, Pseudomonas strata, and Bacillus polymyxa. What is the role of P solubilizing bacteria? What they do? They convert the inorganic form of phosphate which is present in the soil, and by the action of certain enzymes, they convert that inorganic form into the organic form and make it available for the plant growth. Phosphate solubilizing, there are some phosphate solubilizing fungi also, such as Aspergillus niger, Aspergillus evermori, and Penicillium, etc. PSBs increase the crop yield by 10 to 20%. This is P solubilizing bacteria, And the other one is P-mobilizing bacteria. P-mobilizing bacteria are vascular mycorrhiza. They work in symbiotic association between fungi and root of some specific higher plants. In case of PSBs that we discussed earlier, PSBs, they are not in any kind of associations. They are free living bacteria that are present in the soil. But P mobilizing bacteria, they are in symbiotic association with the fungi and root of some specific higher plants only. In symbiotic association means the both partners are benefited. How they function, that the fungi, they absorb nutrients like manganese, phosphorus, iron, zinc, etc. from the soil and pass it to the plant. There is no conversion process, that they are not converting any inorganic form of phosphorus and then passing it to the plant. They're directly absorbing the available form of the plant, that which is somehow which is not easily available, but they absorb that phosphorus from the phosphorus or the nutrients from the soil part and pass it to the plant for their further better growth. The next one is silicate solubilizing bacteria. As the name suggests, that they help in solubilizing the silicates. Silicate solubilizing bacteria can play an efficient role in soil by solubilizing insoluble form of silicates and make it available to the plant. Silicates accelerate the plant growth, and their major role is to increase the leaf area for photosynthesis. They also prepare the plant for against the resistance, or they can also help in help the plant against abiotic stresses. The bacillus species, it's very important and plays a major role in silicate solubilization. The accumulated silicate not only improves the growth and yield of the plant, but it is also involved in the systemic resistance. As I told you, that abiotic stress, it plays its role in against abiotic stresses, and the accumulated silicate also helps in protecting the plant against some pests and diseases. This we discussed about the type of biofertilizers, the three type of biofertilizers: nitrogen, phosphate, and silicate. Now the next question is how these fertilizers are being used, the method of their application. There are basically four type of application methods of biofertilizers. One is seed treatment, then the soil treatment, seedling treatment, and the set treatment. We'll discuss these treatments one by one. Let's start with the seed treatment. Seed treatment, as the name suggests, that in this treatment, the biofertilizers are being applied. They are applied directly on the seed. But how they are applied, we'll discuss at what ratio they are being used. This method is used mainly used for cereals, such as wheat, sorghum, maize, etc., and oil seeds and pulses. The first step of this application, how to use seed treatment, is we'll prepare a culture suspension by mixing biofertilizer and water in a ratio of 1:2. For example, if we are using 200 grams of biofertilizer, then we'll use 400 ml of water. After preparing a culture suspension of biofertilizer and water in ratio of 1:1, this culture suspension is sprinkled over the seed heap and mixed properly to make a thin coating of biofertilizer on seeds. These seeds are dry. The next step is to dry the seeds for some time in shade, and then the further step is sowing. One packet if we talk about the ratio, one packet of biofertilizer, if it's of 200 grams, it is reported that 200 gram of biofertilizer is sufficient to treat 10 to 12 kg of seeds. Next application method is soil treatment. In this method, mixture of biofertilizer and soil is prepared with help of water. We use water as we discussed earlier, that a mixture of biofertilizer and soil, sometimes we can use cattle manure, is sprinkled with water and spread directly on the soil. In seed treatment, seeds are being treated by biofertilizer suspension, but in soil treatment, we are directly applying the suspension on the soil at the sowing time. The amount of biofertilizer varies with duration of crops. For example, if we have a short duration crop, means less than 6 months, then 10 to 15 packets, 200 grams each, is mixed with 40 to 60 kg of organic manure or soil per acre of the land. if we talk about long duration crops, the amount increases from 20 to 30 packets of biofertilizers with mixed with 80 to 120 kg of organic manure or soil per acre of the land. The next treatment is seedling treatment. This method is applied for crops like paddy, onion, chili, etc. because the seedlings, they are dipped. Suspension is prepared in similar way that the biofertilizer is mixed with water in ratio of 1:10. In seed treatment, we mix the ratio was 1:2, but here the ratio is 1:10. The suspension is prepared, then the seedlings are dipped in biofertilizer suspension for 30 minutes. Then the root tips of the plants that we have already dipped, they are transplanted immediately. There is no drying step in the seedling treatment. Next is set treatment. Set treatment is applied for the set of sugar canes, used for the crops like sugar cane, pieces of potatoes, base of banana suckers, etc. In this method, the ratio of biofertilizer to water is 1:50. 1:50 means 1 kilogram of biofertilizer in 50 liters of water. The planting material pieces are immersed in the biofertilizer suspension for 30 minutes. Next step is to dry them in shade for some time before planting. The important step is that after plantation, the field is irrigated within 24 hours. It's a very necessary step to irrigate the fields after plantation within 24 hours. This table describes that we discussed earlier, the different methods of application. This is a summary of that application method, different types of biofertilizer and their application method on different crops. For example, rice is the method of application is seedling, means the root tips are being the tips are being dipped in the biofertilizer suspension and then transplanted, and then plantation was done. In the soybean, seed treatment is used. The seeds are being they're being coated with the biofertilizer suspension, then dried for some time in the shade, and their further the sowing step was followed. Next is benefits of biofertilizers. Biofertilizers increase the crop yield by providing nutrients to plants. They are safe and eco-friendly. They leave no traces of toxins and harmful chemicals into soil and in plant. Biofertilizer helps in increasing the fertility of soil. They suppress disease in plant as well as harmful microorganisms in the soil. Biofertilizers increase the nutrient uptake by the plant by making the nutrients available to the plant. They also produce growth hormones. They are safe to handle as compared to chemical fertilizers. They decreases the dependence on the chemical fertilizers, as chemical fertilizers are not that much safe. They increase the nutritional quality of the final product. We discussed about the types of biofertilizers, the method of application. Now, how biofertilizers are produced commercially. Before starting with the production at the commercial level, we'll discuss it step by step. Then what is the first step? First step is the isolation of bacteria. That bacteria which is capable of, which has a potential of, which is having a biofertilizer potential, which helps, which can enhance the plant growth. The isolation part was done. Then the next step is to select the suitable effective strain. In biofertilizer production or the commercial production, it's very important to know that that strain should be non-pathogenic. We can't go for the pathogenic strains. So this is an important step for biofertilizer development. Isolated bacteria is inoculated in the suitable culture. Preparation of mother or seed culture was done at commercial level. Then we cannot apply biofertilizer or microorganism directly to the field. They need some carrier. With the help of carrier, we can only apply them in the field. So carrier preparation and their mixing was done. The next step is packaging and storage, and then dispatch to the market. There are some biofertilizer producing companies. Few of them are mentioned here, that the National Fertilizer Limited, Niku Bio Research Lab, Nitro Laboratories, and Orissa Agro Industries Corporation Limited. The National Fertilizer Limited Company, NFL, it is a Government of India undertaking body and is producing biofertilizer. And this company made a record of production and dispatch of biofertilizer of 567 metric and 619 metric ton respectively, against the previous best of 506 metric ton in the year of 2014-15. and 605 metric ton in the year of 2013-14 respectively. 530 metric ton of biofertilizer, valuing about around 3.01 crore, and it was sold during the 2015-16 as mentioned in the annual report of NFL 2016. NICU Bioresearch Laboratory. This lab was established in the year 1997 in Pune. As the name suggests itself, that N for natural, I for input, K stands for complete, and U stands for utilization, which means complete utilization of natural inputs for enhancement of crop yields. This table shows the biofertilizer that are produced at NICU Bioresearch Lab and their benefits also. For example, they are producing Rhizonic, the brand name is Rhizonic, which is used against all the rhizobium species. The Azonic, the Azotobacter formulation is being used in the Azonic biofertilizer. The Phosphoniv, that is phosphate solubilizing inoculant, which is the suspension of phosphate solubilizing bacteria. Sulfonic, as name suggests, that is sulfur oxidizing inoculants are used. These are the few fertilizers that are being produced at NICU Bioresearch Lab. We discussed about the four type of treatments, the method of applications. The first one we discussed about the seed treatment, then the seedling treatment, the soil treatment, and the set treatment. We discussed in this module about the benefits of using biofertilizers. As I told earlier, that they are eco-friendly, they are economic, they have no harmful effect on the soil as well as on the other, as well as on the soil microflora. Then we discuss about a few companies which are commercially producing the biofertilizers in India, the NFL, NICU Research, Bioresearch Lab, and Nitrogen. Thank you.